Attention all units, attention all units. Be on the lookout for Angel Devoid. He was last seen heading down city to the Neo City access zone. Positive identification of criminal Angel Devoid. Proceed with extreme caution, Detective Hard.
Like you've had a little bit of an accident. Don't worry, though. I know a doctor fix you up real good. Make you look better than you ever looked before. Mr. Hard, I'm Dr. Sylvanus, the head surgeon of reconstruction. Now, don't try to sit up. The sedative we've just given you should be taking effect in a moment. Your face was damaged very badly, Mr. Hard. Luckily, the medics who brought you in were able to salvage a holographic ID from your ruined PIC. We weren't able to get in touch with any of your emergency contacts. And unless we start reconstruction immediately, there will be irreparable nerve damage and scarring. You understand what I've said to you? Nurse, increase the anesthesia and run an interface to the automated surgeon.
Yes, Doctor.
His face is in too many pieces for me to attempt unassisted reconstruction. I don't want to damage the fine nerves. Everything will be just fine, Star.
Paradise City officials today were shocked to discover that 80 kilos of Trixolite, a highly reactive explosive compound, has been stolen from the Neo City waste site. The Trixolite is said to be powerful enough to destroy much of the city with toxic effects for those within a 100-mile radius. Paradise City police are still on the manhunt for the fugitive, Angel Devoid, who has been linked to the assassination of a council member. Anyone with information on his whereabouts is requested to contact the police department immediately. Researchers at the Faradine Corporation have verified reports that an experimental pack of cyber dogs was liberated by the members of the Actors for Animal Rights Action Group. Faradine scientists are issuing a general warning to all residents of Neo City to avoid the cyber dogs. This is Dana Taylor for Net 7 News.
Seems that your speech center was also damaged during an accident, Mr. Hahn. Your ability to speak will return in time. However, I recommend you stay at home until it does. We don't want you walking around croaking at people now, do we? The reconstructive server seems to be a total success. You're Angel Devoid!
I know who you are. There's a bounty on your head.
You don't have to hide it from me, Jake. Even blind, I recognize you. Nobody else has quite your style. So, what are you doing down here in Neo City? Did Sully assign you to the Trixalite case? You don't have to tell me if you don't want to. You're pretty smart to keep it quiet. Everyone on the street has their ear to the ground on the Trixalite. Even the Yak are worried. Here. Take this. It's a Muck Kyosho 73, top of the line of the handheld plasmas. I always carry two with me, even though they're illegal. I never know when I'm gonna need one, and sometimes one isn't enough. Neo City isn't a safe place, you know, especially if you're a cop. I gotta take off. You be careful down here, Jake. This isn't Paradise City.
A good place to get information. Just be careful you don't make any sudden moves, though. Selena is gun happy.
Lorraine Ruger. A lieutenant on the Paradise City Police Corps, Lorraine Ruger was honorably discharged following a shootout that robbed her of her sight. When cloned implants failed to restore her sight, Lorraine left Paradise City to become a gun for hire in the dangerous underworld of Neo City. It is believed that she has left the city complex to carry out a mission in a neighboring complex. The Honorable Mayor James Waterford, former Terran Council member during the Mars Rebellion James Waterford was elected mayor with little real opposition during a time of prosperity in Paradise City. Serving in his office for 2 terms before his untimely death, Mayor Waterford provided to be a rather ineffectual mayor. Angel Devoid, a former chief of police in Paradise City and commander of the Death 7 Company, Angel Devoid was implicated in a police brutality scandal that resulted in resignation from the force. Shortly afterwards, at a press conference, Devoid killed then-Mayor Waterford and fled to the Warrens of Neo City. It is rumored that his ties to Underworld are many, and that crime bosses throughout the city have put bounties on his head. Something of an enigma, Devoid frequently is reported to appear at different places simultaneously, and his age seems to vary in each encounter. Faradine Cyberdog Pack A1335. Cyberdogs are affectionately known as dogs of war by their Faradine creators, and were originally engineered as remote smart weapons for situations too hostile for human soldiers. Capable of speeds of up to 75 kilometers, group attacks are coordinated via satellite. Cyberdogs are equipped with 69K DPI imaging sensors, low-light compensators, carbide blade teeth and fangs, and bioneural brain slants. Elliot S. Lawrence, once the head of the multinational VR corporation, Nikron Incorporated, Eli's constant drinking and gambling led Nikron down the dark path of bankruptcy. Banished from Paradise City by his former employees, Eli now spends his days looking for spare change among the refuse compactors in Neo City. Dr. Terrence Sylvanus, formerly chief of surgery at Stellar Fields Hospital in Paradise City, Dr. Sylvanus's career took a turn for the worse when he was caught selling stolen organs on the black market. Transferred to a Neo City County hospital, Dr. Sylvanus has been known to accept large sums of money in exchange for favors to certain underworld figures.
That's a nice weapon. It's charged to last you about 700 shots. Looks like it's been modified, too. Auto-tracking, energy reclamation system, inertial inhibitors? You'd better get moving. It's not safe to stay in one place too long down here.
Angel, I didn't think you'd be in this part of the city after... Let me give you a drink. Okay, Angel, okay. I know what you want. I have it right.
The World Web Cash Chip instantly transfers credit for the purposes of business transactions.
Unlike credit cards and accounts of the 20th and 21st centuries, the cash chip represents real money held by the cardholder. It does not approve purchases that will result in a negative balance.
Angel, sing the one-time underground song 6974947. I don't think I know that one. Guess it's not in the top 40.
Chip address is an address book on a single chip card. The chip address carries encrypted information. Only someone with experience breaking complex encryption codes can safely access the information without destroying it. A very powerful explosive compound created using ingredients from both Earth and Mars. Trixolites was originally created by the G9 research team from the Brandt Corporation for the terraforming of Mars. Its possession on Earth is in strict violation of UN laws.
Jake, I can't believe you just did that. What kind of a role model are you, anyway?
A fast-paced gambling game where the bet is multiplied by the face of the thrown die. Trix is the newest and hottest game in Pyramid Casino. Because of the high stakes, only two tables are open at one time. The advantage, as with all games of chance, is with the house.
Trix is simple and fun. These are the rules. The roller receives three dice. He rolls one die at a time. His current bet is multiplied by the face value of the die thrown. If the roller cannot cover this bet, all money applied to that round is forfeited to the bank. A roller wins by throwing any combination divisible by 3, 6, or 9. If the roller throws any combination so divisible, the house bank will pay the roller 150% of the final bet. A bonus of 25% of the final bet will be paid to the roller for any triad thrown. Thank you, Captain.
Now hold on a minute.
Excuse me for my rudeness. But you have a very interesting playing strategy. I'd appreciate it if you could come by my shop sometime soon so we can discuss it. I could offer you some service in return for your secret to winning. Any neighborhood address director can tell you how to get to my shop. Good evening to you, Mr. Devoid.
Mr. Digit's card contains special auto-nav encoding. Slotting this card into a vehicle will allow it to autopilot you to the program destination.
More than a mere device to convey name and occupation, Mr. Digit's business card can be inserted into any neighborhood directory for directions. Alternatively, it can be placed in the autopilot slot on any vehicle to auto-navigate to Mr. Digit's shop.
All Cheyenne Shimato Death Tribe members, coverage at Sector Gamma Larry 126. Bounty product, Angel Devoid spotted. Chief Heroid eliminated from the hunt. Vengeance and bounty.
The subway card has replaced the subway token. The card holds a pre-purchased number of subway rides, allowing the holder to gain access to the city public transit system until the card is used up. access slot allows passengers to pay for their trips on board the city transit system. If it detects a counterfeit subway car, it emits a low-level stun and alerts security. If no security guards are available, the stun setting is raised to kill, and automated cleaning robots dispose of the remains.
Down there on the track. It looks like a military class 5 weapon.
My God, if it isn't Angel Devoid. It's been too long since I've seen your ugly face. Well, Captain, why don't you come inside and you can buy me a drink?
That looks like a rough bar. Death 7. That's an old name, a reference to an elite troop of soldiers. They disbanded years ago, though.
Where did you disappear to? I thought you were going to buy me a drink. After 2 years, don't you think you owe me one?
What's your poison? Right.
Well, you sure did pick quite the night to be here. It's
quite an alive fish tank in the old life of lives, if you know what I'm saying.
Yes, sir. Well, these two pontoon reverse shows are on the house.
Enjoy. Need anything? My name is Bud. I can tell you're a pro. Give me a copy.
What the hell are you doing on this side of town? I bet you're too good for the rest of us sharks. Not talking, huh? Well, that's okay. I've been there myself plenty of times. I know I haven't seen you in a couple of years, but something's very different about you. You're in Flow Zone? I can't place it. But you're just not yourself. I see it now. You've gotten soft, haven't you? You sit up in your fancy apartment and drink yourself stupid. You tell yourself how much better you are than the rest of us from Death 7. When it comes right down to it, you don't have the guts anymore. Or do you? Remember this game? I set the grenade timer and you have 5 seconds to enter the right combination of numbers before it explodes. Why don't we play it now? Remember, 3 tries in your day. I knew you wouldn't let me down, Angel, old man. You still have that steel spine that made all of us follow you back on Mars base, even though it meant we were all doomed. It's too bad the Terran Alliance stabbed us in the back. Too bad for all of us. Now you just wish you to reclaim the past. Let me give you this. This card will get you through any door in the city. It's got a special override chipset. Insert that card into the security panel. It will cause the panel to short out once you're through the door. I don't know who or what you're looking for. But I hope you save enough rounds for the people who made us what we are. As for me, I'm on vacation. Getting out of the city after my shift is over. Get out of here. Some of the locals here are bounty hunters. They'll skin you alive if they see you here.
The Honorable Mayor James Waterford. Neurodancers. The neurodancers at the Pyramid Casino represent the latest and best in neuro-holographic design, specially created to fulfill the desires of anyone with enough credit. Neurodancers dance for the pleasure of their economically endowed patrons. Selena Mariah and Tana Jerome. Selena Jerome is the proprietrix of one of Neo City's most dangerous bars. An alleged gun runner, money launderer, and software pirate, Selena carries more firepower than a squad of Paradise City cops. It is rumored that she once had romantic ties to Angel Devoid, a shadowy underworld figure, but that the relationship ended explosively when local crime organizations placed a bounty on Devoid's head. Chief Serrano Machico. The clan leader of the Cheyenne Shimado Death Tribe, Machico took on the role of chief when the legendary chief, Jeroko Itanayo, named him as his successor upon his death. Within the tribe, it is said that Machico defeated 14 opponents to the succession in combat. Nothing is known of Machico's childhood or early youth, except that he joined the Cheyenne Shimado at age 12 and became a spear carrier within 6 months. Alito DeFreeze. After serving a far too short sentence for killing his wife, Alito applied for and received a license to dispense frozen goods in Neo City. It is generally rumored that Alito uses his role as an ice cream man as a cover to dispense goodies other than ice cream. Alito's use of an environment suit is due to a medical condition developed in prison that requires constant monitoring and regulation of his body temperature. Unknown, specializing in encryption analysts and further access denied to encrypted INET files. Denied, denied, Denied. Denied. Jet Jackson. A soldier in the Death 7 outfit, Jet Jackson served with Angel Devoid on Mars during the uprisings. Discharged from the army due to excessive injuries sustained during that confrontation, Jet now owns and operates the Death 7 Bar, a favorite hangout of other veterans and rough types. Jet is extremely aggressive and is known to have a sick sense of humor. Leon was a bouncer at the Pyramid Casino. Arms Johnson is a former bare knuckles boxer from Neo Detroit. New to Neo City, Arms found a place on the bouncer circuit, working his way up through the dives and bars in the shadowy zones to the Pyramid Casino. Former employee of Selena Jerome.
My database files show these tunnels to be extremely old. Watch your step.
The flashlight is one of the finer models on the market, and self-activates when it senses the heat of a human hand. The custom batteries are guaranteed for 10 years of use, and the compact halogen slat is designed to outlive the human race.
Access granted.
What do you want? Oh my God, you're Angel Devoid. Jimmy was so stupid for trying to cheat you. such a show-off. But he thought he'd be alive to make the deal. You must have seen the dogs. They got you. He thought he could outrun them. The wetware is in the fridge. Go ahead and take it. Jimmy is dead. I can't use it. Just go away. Leave me alone!
Looks like a chipset, custom wetware, probably. You'll have to get an expert to look at this. I'm not programmed for decryption. Deodorant.
Selena Nunes, former model for the AnoComp Neurodancer Generation 3. Melina was put out of work when AnoComp was bought by Nikron mogul Elliot S. Lawrence. Her connections to the wetware underground allowed her to interface with a series of pirates and designers. Her last known associate was James Altro, a wetware expert and smuggler. The Reverend Jerry Gold. Operating a cyber church in Neo City, the Reverend Gold makes a comfortable living reconciling the masses to a cybernetic deity. It is rumored, however, that the Reverend Gold deals in securities frauds and black market drugs. Neo City police have been unable to substantiate these allegations. The Reverend Gold has been the recipient of 4 cloned heart transplants, necessitated by a high-fat, high-sodium diet.
Ah, Mr. Devoid. So pleased to see you again. I take it you have something to show me. My, my, what have we here? This is beautifully done. Quite a feat of craftsmanship. You see this symbol here? This chip carries medical information. Unfortunately, the encryption program used is a localized entity and would cannibalize my entire system. You're going to have to take this one to a clinic to have it analyzed. Chip looks like a simple information retrieval system. All public information. See here. This could be anything. Let me see which level of encryption it has. I'll bet no higher than a 3. Not even a level 1.
Mr. Mayor, much speculation has arisen concerning the sudden call for dismissal of Chief Devoid. Is it true that higher levels of the Paradise government are forcing Chief Devoid out?
Absolutely not, and I'd like to address that. Chief Devoid and the department have reached an amicable agreement. Let me stress that there is definitely no conspiracy in the higher echelons of government. We determined that it was in the best interest of the department.
Two years ago, a conspiracy almost killed me, but I'm not gonna let it happen this time. The mayor and the other conspirators who tried to force me out are gonna have to pay the price for trying to destroy a man who's already comfortable living with his own death.
The date on this is over 5 years ago. You certainly do seem to get around, Mr. Devoid. But your past is of no consequence to me. This is military. I'm afraid also out of my range. I don't know where to tell you to take this one. It's likely to contain information that is... that is illegal to be possessed by civilians. This is a fairly complex database program. I've worked with it before, you see. It has 17 levels of encryption. It's going to take me the better part of a day to get through this one. I'm going to have to close up shop for a while. Come back later, and I'll have the results of the chip address.
You suck, Digit!
A little strange, but who isn't down here? He seems pretty smart, though. You'd better get moving before someone sees you. We'll come back later.
A slimline Conitech Generation 5 machine, Mr. Digit's computer is sleek and customized for breaking high-level security codes. Sporting 128 gigabytes of RAM, the CPU is capable of processing over 512,000 instructions per clock cycle. Mr. Digit's collection of documentation pertaining to all hardware includes Holovision M880, Data Recall X11, and the PD112 info server.
Jake, transmissions from Death Tribe headsets indicate a planned full assault. You better use that override card Jet gave you. Now! Now! That was a close call. I thought my circuit boards were dog food for sure.
Hey, hey, Slick! Slick! Give your feet a rest. Come on, get in. I'll give you a ride downtown. Come on, I'll show you a good time. Get in.
If this keeps up, someone will spot you. Let's get in. At least you'll be safe inside the cab.
Walking, haven't you? Yeah, you don't walk. Me, I don't like to walk. I won't walk. I can't drive there. I don't get there. You know what I'm saying, Slick? Exactly right. Well, there's some trap in there. This is bad.
I'm telling you, you're lucky you got me as your cab driver. I'm serious, you're lucky, because, you know, a lot of cabbies, they don't care. They just don't care. I mean, they'll run you right up the tailpipe of a bus, a toxic carrier, whatever, you know. See, with all these designer diseases and all that, you don't need no toxic nothing.
Right.
You don't talk that much, do you, Slim? Not a big talker? Yeah, people say I talk a lot. I don't think I talk a lot. But really, I don't. I don't think I talk that much. But some people think I talk a lot. Now, my sister, now she can talk. She's like a world champion talking. She's going off every which way. You got to jam an apple in your mouth to get a word in edgewise. That's my life. You know, that's me. What about you? You know, who do you think's going to win that? Just been harpooned.
Hey, come on, what's going on here? I'm paid up. Everything, jeez.
Dragging us down, it. Slick, they're dragging us down. Is it? Is there something you're not telling me? Come on, Slick. Slick, are you wanted, man? Are you wanted?
Go, Dan. Meet your new roommate. The bounty hunter that brought Angel in wanted to get the full price for bringing him in alive. But when we told him you'd be sharing his cell, well, let's just say he settled for a lower price. Try not to lose his teeth so we can identify the buyer.
Say that you were a big hero on Mars base. That the bios the Terrans let loose kill most of your men off in the first 5 hours. But you made it out with 50 first class sharks. I had a friend who didn't. Triggered an aggressive response. So I killed a few people. So what, 15 or 20 people anyway? New City is overcrowded. And we all need a little breathe. Search you? Because the suicide rate is over 80% in here. And the guards would just keep what they find on your body. You want to know a secret? They should have searched me. Getting out of here.
Shut up, you fake guy. What do you want?
The World Web Cash Chip instantly transfers credit for the purposes of business transactions. Unlike credit cards and accounts of the 20th and 21st centuries, the cash chip represents real money held by the cardholder. It does not approve purchases that will result in a negative balance.
That's a med chip. Zio, take him to the media analysis room.
This will take a skin sample to determine whether or not you have the disease. Personally, I think whoever did the original scan on you and recorded it in this chip was an idiot. Anyone with an advanced case of Rita's syndrome couldn't be walking around unless they were heavily sedated. Or they'd never stop screaming! The only cure for Rita's syndrome is Aegisys 4. Unfortunately, it's very lethal to those who don't have the disease. Besides, it's very illegal to possess. There. That's enough of a sample. Now, take that. Put it in any phone, and the results of your test will be downloaded and displayed on the video screen. Now, if you don't mind, I have quite a few patients to see.
Inductee to the fierce Cheyenne Shimado Death Tribe, formerly a resident of the Home for Troubled Youths. Violent and proficient in three illegal martial arts, Marion's fierce loyalty to her clan is outweighed only by her devotion to the clan chief, Sha Arano Machiko. Unknown. Positive identification of subject through INET records not possible. Subject may be a refugee from a neighboring city complex. Please report last known location of subject to INET agents for processing. Area Dot Service Model 3A, Drudy. A guide robot, Drudy is currently in service in the Neo City Health Clinic. The ASM-3A is equipped with several medical emergency programs and functions as a temporary A1 medical technician. Its capabilities are limited, however, and functions best when ushering visitors to their destinations.
Dan Floss. A veteran of the Mars War, Dan Floss was stationed aboard the Terran heavy cruiser Belovsky. Caught in the engineering section during a fierce firefight, Floss was struck in the head by debris. In order to compensate for damaged brain tissue, Floss had violence inhibitor implants. Unfortunately, the inhibitors are substandard. Since returning to Neo City, Floss has developed an extensive criminal record. Mark David Elijah Bergstrom. One of Neo City's more polite residents, Bergstrom is a licensed cab driver and psychologist. While his fares are substantially higher than those of cabbies who do not practice psychoanalysis, Bergstrom is famous for getting his customers where they want to go. Dr. Anton Garnett. While acting out the role of public servant, Anton Garnett is one of the most respected neurologists in both Neo and Paradise Cities. The inventor of the micronerve, Dr. Garnett has made great strides forward in the regeneration of damaged nerve tissue. Rather than pursuing money and fame, however, Dr. Garnett spends his days in Neo City tending to the wretched and infirm. Maggie Randolph Kinsey. As a desk nurse to the Neo City Health Clinic, Maggie makes sure patients get routed to the proper areas in the clinic. She's a hard worker and doesn't take crap from anyone.
Up fantastic amounts of electromagnetic energy from the end of the hall. Be careful. Getting too close could scramble my logic functions. Think you humans can't do jack. You surprise me.
Just a minute. I never thought I'd see you alive again. Hey, come on in. I've got some pre-war beer, some flake Tory like we used to eat on... I must be getting old. You don't look like you've aged much in the past 7 years. Well, come on in. When was the last time we saw each other before? Court-martial, wasn't it? Self-righteous bastards. Thank you. Captain. How can I help? Captain, this reminds me of the old days back on Mars base before the Terrans. Well, you'd remember that even better than me. This is a Death 7 chip. Have you been carrying this around with you for the past 7 years? I bet this has the old encryption code. What is this? This isn't Mars base. It's a map of the city. What's going on? You're acting like you don't know anything. I may be old, but I can figure it out. You're planning to blow up the city. Now, I don't have a grudge against every man, woman, and child in Neo City. If you do, that's your business. But even so, I have a business to operate, even if you do incinerate everything in Neo City and Paradise City. So I want you to walk out of here. Oh, good luck with your carnage.
Angel is. You better stop him or get out of the city. I don't want my circuits spilled all over a wasteland.
Identification being processed. Welcome to Storage Facility A5, Captain Devoid. Please wait here for your escort.
Please excuse the mess. Thankfully, security robots are not as reliable. Please stand on the platform, Captain.
military equipment, Jake. It should be okay to look around, but be careful. There may be a trap.
This is an old photo of Angel Devoid with Jet and Selena. This glove is part of an experimental battle suit. It has DNA sensors that activate a deadly booby trap should an unauthorized person attempt to utilize it. Various modern sculptures of morphing materials are located throughout the gallery.
It's really horrific to look at, isn't it? My father was an engineer there. Not really attached to the Mars-based provisional government. But when the Terrans decided that Mars had been long enough without some sort of order, civilians just weren't important. My mother and father both died there. I had a 6-year-old sister. She was killed in a firefight. The Death 7 found me hiding under a bed and took me to a transport. I was exposed to the bios. Let's go out to the balcony. It's supposed to have a really beautiful view of the city. Probably the only beautiful view of the city. Come on.
Several of the pictures are impressionistic, but many realistically depict the horrors of modern life. One picture in particular deals with the carnage of the Mars War.
You should keep moving around. I'm jamming the security cameras, but you never know.
This is? It's Exus 4. It's made in space and smuggled onto Earth. It's illegal because it violates the anti-gene manipulation laws. It's also the only thing that keeps me alive. Keeps my DNA from turning into soup. Are you hot? I feel like I'm burning up from the inside. When I was a little girl, I used to dream of living in a building so high that when you look down, all the people look like ants. Look at that. The people look like ants.
A lot of people on Mars were exposed to the biological weapons, the bios. Most of them were civilians. Such a tragedy.
Gray Hirsch. A soldier of fortune, Gray Hirsch served in the Death 7 Company during the Mars War. Injured and left for dead, Hirsch made his way back to the company rendezvous point minutes before the final evacuation. Bitter, Hirsch resigned his commission and took to selling arms on the black market. Tanako Smith Guy Droid Series F. The Guy Droid is designed to transport and protect visitors in sensitive areas. Implemented for insurance reasons, the Guy Droid is equipped with a small compressor cannon and other standard combat equipment. Faradine Security Droid Series A-111. One of Faradine's more stable creations, the security droid is designed to anticipate and handle threats to security. Early models of this series may have overcompensation circuits in their aggression grids due to a production flaw, causing them to malfunction in violent ways. Deidre Kanes. A child during the Mars War, Deidre was evacuated from the doomed Mars colony and resettled in Neo City with her relatives. Passed from home to home because of her increasing psychological disturbances, Deidre turned to art as a means of expressing her inner turmoil. Deidre suffers from Reader's disease, an incurable and eventually fatal neurological disorder.
Lines are busy. Please try later. Medical test completed. Downloading data. Subject, Angel Devoid. Age, 30. Height, 1.85 meters. Weight, 79 kilograms. Residence, unknown. Occupation, unknown. Relative, unknown. Results of DNA process scan. Batch number Sigma 7899058675 Omega. Reader syndrome, negative. Neurological disorder, negative. HIV, negative. EM resonance, positive. Electromagnetic scan results based on comparison to previous DNA base of Devoid Angel. Possible causes for EM variants. Exposure to rare isotopic materials, negative. Exposure to marginally toxic materials, negative. Exposure to electrostatic charge over 15,000 volts, negative. DNA drift due to cloning variants, positive. DNA drift is often found in the result product of accelerated cloning because the replicating DNA is encouraged to evolve a clone to level of the parent age.
Hey, you're Angel Devoid. Hey, everyone! It's Angel Devoid! He's got a bounty on his head!
Please insert destination card. Destination, Mr. Digit Shop. Prepare for takeoff.
Thank you.
Ah, there you are. You are not going to believe this. It seems the whole thing was some kind of a joke. The address contained on the chip is to the sewer. Can you believe it? I was so angry when I discovered it that I practically bit off my tongue. I'm sorry, Mr. Devoid. I really had hoped the information would be interesting.
Wow, guess he was really depressed. Why would somebody want Trixalite delivered to the sewer?
Jerry DiNardi, a fry cook at Neo City's Grease Grill, is a cyber school dropout. Currently residing with his mother and two aunts, DiNardi also acts as a courier for Combat Corporation, a weapons manufacturer.
Let me tell you a story before you blow my brains out. That is what they say, isn't it? Very well. Relax for a few minutes. I'm sure you want to know what's going on. Why you are who already a lieutenant. My commissions just kept on coming. Soon I was captain of Death's Seven, a very elite group of soldiers, and I was very proud to have led them. Then came the war. We sided with the forces loyal to the Mars Provisional Government. It was hard. Home, after all. We loved the place. After terraforming the planet, the colonists felt it was their right to sympathize with Terra. Why should they work so hard to export raw materials to a planet that was already overcrowded with the dregs of society? But Earth, oh, I'm sorry, Terra, saw it differently. First, they bombarded the planet with artificial asteroids. They caused as much damage as nuclear bombs without radioactive side effects. When we dug in and refused to come out, they released the bios. Killed thousands of children. Not soldiers, you understand. Children! Eventually I escaped. Part of my company and a handful of civilians. We stole shuttles and returned to Earth. Military police were waiting for me. Was court-martialed, but later acquitted. Promar's Senate began to rot surface under Congress. But I have my revenge. The men who gave those orders to release the bios, the scientists that made those bios, are here. 7 years ago, I had some genetic material taken from my body, hidden away. And when I returned, I began to make clones. Jake, you are the last clone I made of myself. Choice. This is the transmitter that will set off the charges. You could take this from me, but then you'd have to kill me. You see, I always knew you would come for me. I knew you'd be the last one. Zircon. You should be the only one. Who knows, maybe you can go to the Mars base. Bias have died out. Some stories to return. Well, what's it gonna be, Jake? Are you finally an angel? You see, I always knew you would come for me.
Are you enjoying your flight, sir?
Yes, I am.
Have you ever been to Mars before?
Not for a long, long time.
Take this from me, but then you'd have to kill me.
Angels, what's going on here? You better come down to the station with us. If you just kill the real Angel Devoid, you've saved two cities. We understand you plan to blow up both Neo City and Paradise City.
Thank you.
I'm picking up weapon signatures from multiple locations. May I suggest getting off this roof?
Department delivered. It's the high and mightiest Angel Devoid. If you're here for that credit card that I hid for you, just forget it. After the last party you threw here, I had to use it to pay for all the damages. Besides, the Yacht is looking for you, and I'm already paying them more protection money than I can afford. Don't tell me you can't trust your old friend Selena, after all we've been through together. Go ahead and drink it. It's on the house. I don't want any more trouble from the Yak, or the Death Tribes, or anyone else you've double-crossed in the last 2 weeks. You know what a fine line I have to walk here. I have the cops on the right side, I have the Yak on the left. If anyone found out I was even talking to you, I think you should just leave. Doing here? Are you trying to get me closed down? I don't need any death tribes barging in here killing off my good customers. Anyway, I heard you were already dead. Go ahead. You're entitled to one drink on the house, but just one, and then you have to get out of here. On your back. Who should I call? Dom? The Yak? How about the cops? Even they're offering money for you. Your scaly carcass is going to make me rich.
Down there on the track. It looks like a military class 5 weapon.
You've got that crazy look in your eye, Angel. Just like the time you killed that general. No one can get through you when you're in a state of mind like that. I think you ought to leave. Right now. Since you've lost your manners, along with your commission, let me give you a piece of advice. Death tribes hang here all the time. They come for drinks like clockwork. Get out of here now. I won't tell them which way you went for old time's sake.
To follow me. Jimmy was so stupid for trying to cheat you. He said you'd be here to make the deal, but he thought he'd be alive. You must have seen the cyber dogs. They got you. He thought he could outrun them. You don't even care, do you? All you care about is your own stupid agenda. Well, if you want the wetware, you're going to have to kill all those cyber dogs. Because he had it on him when they took him down. I think he should leave now. Don't you?
The clan of Cheyenne Shimado has been avenged.
I want his head.
You don't care about it at all, do you? You could really care less. You rotten bastard! I'll show you how much I don't care either. It's Herbo. We're both going out of here the hard way!
It's a map of the city. What's going on? Each one of these glowing points represents a detonation point, and then they're all linked structurally to the thermal furnaces in Paradise City. Now, if you blow these up, you're gonna blow up not only Paradise City, but Neo City as well. You're out of your mind. I want you to walk out of here. And don't come back. It's a map of the city. What's going on? Hey, don't shoot, Captain. I can keep my mouth shut. Now, what do I care if you blow up Neo City? Just don't shoot me.
It's Angel Devoid! He's got a bounty on his head!
Oh. I'm gonna make some money off of you.
Welcome to storage facility A5, Captain Devoid. Please wait here for your escort.
Thank you.